الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله تبارك وتعالى، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة. عباد الله، all thanks and praise is to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We thank Him, we praise Him, we seek His help and we seek His forgiveness. And we seek refuge in Allah from the evil within our own selves and from our bad deeds. Whosoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides, no one can lead astray. And whosoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala lead astray, no one can guide. And I bear witness that there is no one worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his final messenger. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, in the meanings of which, O you who believe, ittaqullah, obey Allah, be dutiful to Allah the way He ought to be obeyed, and do not die except as Muslims. O mankind, be dutiful to your Lord, the one that created you from one soul, and from it He created its mate, and from them both He created many men and women. So fear Allah through whom you demand your mutual rights. Allah indeed is all watcher over you. O you who believe, obey Allah, fear Allah, and always speak the truth. He will guide you to do righteous good deeds, and He would forgive you your sins. And whosoever obeys Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has indeed achieved a great success. The best speech is the speech of Allah, the Quran. The best guidance is the guidance of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the worst of the matters are the new invented matters in the religion. And every new invented matter in the religion, bid'ah, is an astray. We are witnessing the best days of one's life, the best days of the year, as the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam stated that أفضل الأيام أفضل أيام الدنيا, the best days of this world, this life, is أيام العشر, is the 10 days of the Hijjah. And we're about to witness the best of it, which is the day of Arafah, and after that the day of النحر, the day of Eid, and أيام التشريق. These days are the days of our Eid, أمة الإسلام, as the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, he said in the authentic hadith, يوم عرفة ويوم النحر وأيام التشريق عيدنا, أيام عيد, these are the days of عيد, us, for us, أمة الإسلام, the Ummah of Islam, those who submitted themselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Ummah, they become all together, تجتمع الأمة كلها, all the Ummah get together in these days. A party of them, they are in Hajj. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easy for them and to accept from them. They are the delegation of this ummah going to the best spots on the face of earth, replying to the call from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as an obligation once in lifetime to fulfill this pillar of Islam. That's why the fadila and the virtue of these days is because of the five pillars of Islam are established. There's no fadila, there is no virtue except with the good deeds. And that's why these days are the best days. Because of the honor of the days and the honor of the place. Those who went for Hajj, today is the day of Yawm al-Tarwiyah, the 8th of the Hijjah, where the Hajjaj are in Mina. And they're preparing themselves, praying Dhuhr and Asr and Maghrib and Isha and Fajr in Mina. The 4 rak'ah they pray it too. Even if they are from the people of Mecca, they still pray the Dhuhr rak'ah 2 rak'ah and the Asr 4 rak'ah and the Isha 2 rak'ah. This is part of the Nusuk, part of the rituals that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught this ummah to observe in the days of Hajj. And then after Fajr for the next day, they proceed after sunrise to Arafah. And Arafah is the Hajj. As the Prophet ﷺ, he said, Al-Hajju Arafah. And the virtues of the day of Arafah are something that beyond our comprehension. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned it in the Quran, وَشَاهِدٍ وَمَشْهُودٍ, which is the day of Arafah. And the Prophet ﷺ, he said, in many different ahadith shows the virtue of the day of Arafah, that مَا مِنْ يَوْمٍ يُرَى الشَّيْطَانُ أَحْقَرُ. There is no days where the shaitan is seen the most humiliated, وَأَغْيَظُ, the more inferior, and the more infuriated and angry than the day of Arafah. Why? Because he sees the rahmat, the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is descending upon the people. And this is not just for the people of Arafah, this is for the entire ummah, insha'Allah ta'ala, by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's the day where the most day where people will be freed from the hellfire. Tears are shed, the dua is accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is proud of the people, those who are present in Arafah, in front of the angels, because they came shu'athan ghubra, uncombed, dusty, they come without any form of beauty or adornment whatsoever. All of their shi'ar and their way and what they're saying and what they're about is labbaik Allahumma labbaik, labbaik la sharika laka labbaik, innal hamda wal ni'mata laka wal mulk la sharika lak. Labbaik, replying to the call from Allah. Wa adhim fi an-nasi bil hajj, one call, walillahi ala an-nasi hajjul bayt. The hearts are leaning towards it every year. The Muslims, they send their delegations, and those who are not, they wish they can go one time after another. Replying to the call from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and stating the tawheed of Allah. La sharika laka labbaik. He has no partners in creation, in worship, in his names and attributes. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, all the perfect praises to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The dominion of the heavens and the earth belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they all go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala seeking the pleasure and the forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ما من يوم أكثر من أن يعتق الله فيه عبدا من النار من يوم عرفة. As the Prophet ﷺ said, there is no day more likely that a person will be freed from the hellfire more than the day of Arafah. So the virtue of it is something that is beyond our comprehension. And the best thing, as the Prophet ﷺ, he said, خير الدعاء دعاء يوم عرفة. The best dua is the dua of the day of Arafah. وخير ما قلت أنا والنبيون من قبلي يوم عرفة لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير. Which is also declaring كلمة التوحيد with the تلبية, with the توحيد, with the تكبيرات of the عيد afterwards. And this is where it starts for them after صلاة الظهر. And the same thing for the ummah of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. شرع لهم, part of our deen which is recommended to fast in the day of Arafah. For those who are able to fast. And the Prophet ﷺ, he said that he seek from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the reward or the acceptance that this fasting of the day of Arafah expiates the sins of 2 years. السنة الماضية والسنة القابلة. 2 years, the present year and the past one. 2 years of sins to be expiated as a result of fasting the day of Arafah, which is tomorrow, Saturday. It is not permissible for the people in Hajj to fast. This is special for those who are not in Hajj, as a mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for them to have something in common with them. And as the ulama, they say the forgiveness is there for the rest of the ummah if they observe what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from them. The being freed from the hellfire is also valid for those who are not in Hajj by the mercy of Allah and the niyyah of the person. One's intentions goes beyond one's actions. And all of that is by the mercy of Allah. And more important, not more important than actions, but one of the great matters that we need to observe in the day of Arafah. Why the day of Arafah is exalted? The ayah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed unto the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam while he is waqif fi ashiyati Arafah, in Arafah, while the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam standing invoking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam this part of the ayah: Al-yawma akmaltu lakum dinakum wa atmamtu alaykum ni'mati wa raditu lakum al-islam deena. This is the day where it's Eid. It was Jumu'ah, it was the day of Arafah. And a Jew came to Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, and he was the Khalifa. And he said, Ayah, ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, one verse in your book, O leader of the faithful. لو نزلت علينا معشر يهود. If this ayah was revealed unto us, the Jews, we would take that day as a Eid, as a day of festivity. He said, what ayah? He said, اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. عمر رضي الله عنه, he said, I know when it was revealed and where it was revealed. Revealed to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام عشية عرفة, after ظهر time for the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام in the day of Arafah. And this ayah, which is one of the greatest favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon this ummah, the greatest favor upon this ummah, that this deen has been completed and perfected. اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم. On this day, the day of Arafah, I had perfected your religion for you. وأتممت عليكم نعمتي, and completed my favor and perfected my favor upon you. ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا, and I am pleased for you to have the deen of Islam as your religion. Three things from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to this ummah, which is the best ever. The first one, إكمال الدين. This is something that we need to witness. The deen has been completed. The deen has been completed. There is no room for any addition to it or anything to be taken from it. من أحدث في أمرنا هذا ما ليس منه فهو رد. As the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, he said, whoever introduced anything in this matters of others, which is the religion, it will be rejected against that person. Matters of aqidah, matters of belief, it's perfect, it's complete, with all the details that the human beings are in need of to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to believe the perfect belief. The matters of ahkam and rulings and halal and haram, and that's why it was said after this verse was revealed to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, there was no halal and haram revealed to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam afterwards. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala perfected it. Al-akhlaq, manners, anything that purifies the hearts, anything that would make the person fulfill the purpose of their life, it's been established in this deen of Allah. And what that means is, it means that we need to learn this beautiful religion. We need to learn it. We need to witness with our hearts how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala completed it and perfected it. To learn the matters of belief, the matters of the ahkam, the halal and the haram, our ibadah, the five daily salah and so on. And the akhlaq and the relationships, everything is governed by the deen of Allah, our wealth, transactions, halal and haram. وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي, and my favor has been bestowed upon you perfectly, for the fact that no one will enter Jannah unless they are followers of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِي غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا فَلَنْ يُقْبَلَ مِنْهُ وَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. Whoever seeks and takes other than the deen of Islam as his religion, it won't be accepted from him in the day of judgment, and he will be among the losers. So those who are followers of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, this is the greatest favor that a person can attain in this life. The forgiveness of the sins. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ وَيُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. This is ummatun marhuma. This is an ummah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed. And the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends upon this ummah. And put aside those who would say otherwise. It's not about the physical beings of this ummah. It's the fact that there is no ummah on the face of earth worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone except ummatul Islam. There is no ummah has a perfect book like the book of Allah, the Quran. There is no ummah that Allah is pleased with except the ummah of al-Islam if they follow the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-yawma akmaltu lakum deenakum wa atmamtu alaykum ni'mati wa raditu lakum al-Islam deena. I'm pleased for you to have the religion of al-Islam as your religion. Any other religion on the face of earth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not pleased with. It's been altered, it's been changed. The only religion of al-haqq, of the truth on the face of earth, since the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام was sent till the day of judgment, إسلام الوجه لله. To submit oneself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to follow the deen of Islam, to follow the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Every messenger was sent to his people. And if his people would reject him, they are disbelievers. If they die on that state after the message reaches them, they are from the people of the Hellfire. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam was sent to all mankind. He's the prophet of all those who exist today and from the time of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And the duty of the Muslim is to spread the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because there's no messenger to come after the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and the message has been perfected. This was revealed in the day of Arafah, to witness that with our hearts, to live our life, to make our hearts and our actions upon these meanings, to perfect our life according to the perfect way of life, which is the deen of Islam. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، والعاقبة للمتقين، ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. عباد الله, these virtues are associated with actions. It's not just virtues in the air, but we with our actions, we establish this in our life with the ibadah to Allah, establishing the obligations that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered us to observe, to stay away from what Allah forbade us, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is malikul mulk, the owner of all things. Who are we to dictate for ourselves what's good and what is bad? Human beings, they fail miserably. They can't. They cannot afford it. They don't have the ability for it. The deen of Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala perfected it. The halal and the haram, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala perfected it. Everything is perfect in the deen of Allah, but we need to go back and learn it how it was at the time of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, and to be firm upon this. And in the day of Arafah, with the virtue of it, and the expiations of the sins, and being freed from the hellfire, and the shaitan is seen to be humiliated on that day because of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon this ummah. So one of the things also to be observed, if a person is seeking the forgiveness from Allah and the expiations of the sins, is to guard one's actions, is to guard one's eyesight and one's hearing, to make it only according to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with. It doesn't go together when someone is seeking expiation of sins while he is indulging in sins, but rather to purify ourselves and to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And after the day of Arafah is the day of An-Nahr. This is also one of the best days, and there's differences of opinions. Which is the best day of the year? Yawm Arafah or Yawm An-Nahr, because of the hadith of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. The concept of sacrifice and the duty, and you heard about the rulings of it, of what we observe. But the concept of it, the hearts to be purified by it, and to remember Ibrahim alayhi salam and the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam, and how he was shown the rituals and manasik al-hajj for this ummah to follow, to worship none but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. All of these things required for each and every one of us to observe it, to be proud of who we are, to submit ourselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fully, and not to have any barriers between us and this submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees what's in the hearts. The early generations of Islam in the day of Arafah, they used to be in different ways. Some of them would put more of al-khawf, the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As al-Fudayl ibn Iyad rahimahullah, he was standing in the day of Arafah, kept on making dua and invoking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or he was silent. He's as if he's, every time he want to make dua, tears would overpower him. Every time he wants to make dua, tears overpower him. Till before sunset, he said, wa sawatahu wa in afawt, woe to me even if you pardon me, out of the shyness from Allah. Shyness from Allah that He subhanahu wa ta'ala, the owner of all things. And when we look at ourselves and our weaknesses and deficiencies, but He's the most merciful. And He created us weak and deficient so that we turn to Him alone subhanahu wa ta'ala. And some of them, as Sufyan al-Thawri rahimahullah, when someone asked him, for those who are present in the day of Arafah, who are the worst person among them? He said, the one that thinks that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would not forgive him. He's the worst person on that day. Because of the vast mercy of Allah. So to have good expectations of Allah, to subject ourselves to the mercy of Allah, to the dua, to make the dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us steadfast upon the deen, because this is the mean for every goodness that happens in this life and in the hereafter. To make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the ummah of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, for the Muslims everywhere in the entire world, whether it's in Palestine, in Gaza, in Sudan, in every place on the face of earth, to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not to transgress in our dua, but to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for what is best for them and for ourselves, to hold fast to the deen of Allah, to give us victory, to aid us, to make us among those who are steadfast upon the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us witness these days and to make us steadfast upon the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahumma aqsim lana min khashyatika ma tahulu bihi baynana wa bayna ma'asiyatik. ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا ومتعنا اللهم بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقوتنا أبدا ما أبقيتنا واجعله الوارث منا واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا وانصرنا على من عادانا ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك فينا ولا يرحمنا اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعاء. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وأقم الصلاة.